Welcome to our premier lacrosse league coverage from the greater Toronto area tonight. Third and final game of week 9 from Tim Hortons Field in Hamilton. Whipsnakes and Redwoods trying to clarify the PLL playoff picture. Right now, neither Whipsnakes or Redwoods have clinched a spot. A Whips win would lock up one of the top two spots in the playoffs, which is a decided advantage in the PLL playoff format. But a loss in a scenario remains in play that could have them completely missing the playoffs heading into the final weekend in Albany. For Redwoods, they can still finish anywhere from second to fifth, and they will leapfrog the Whips in the standings with a win. So what do we know? Chrome is out, Chaos is in, everyone else clawing for a spot in the top four.
This defense has not been up to their typical standards the last few weeks. They need to perform better. It starts with Bryce Young. He's going to have the matchup with Henningberg today. Shifting gears to the midfield, Mike Chanichuk, the most two-point attempts in the league. Troutner has struggled. Expect him to be firing from long range. Connor Kelly moved to attack last week, responded with his best outing. Can he keep it rolling again this week?
But as we mentioned, no Eddie Glazer.
Yeah, so John Sexton, they'll bump him down from the long stick midfield position to that close D. Keep our eyes on that, playing a little bit out of his normal spot. Salcido has been so consistent for them. They need other midfielders to step up, Walters and Harrison specifically. And lastly, with the attack, with Kavanaugh also out, Garnsey gets the start and attack. He has been arguably the rookie of the year so far. Let's see if we get more of his creative, dynamic plays today.
Well, he goes up against Joe Nardella today, the Rutgers product, third of the PLL in faceoff percentage after struggling with Connor Farrell last week. Last meeting between these two teams, he took advantage of the injured Grenlian, Nardella winning 21 of 27. Grenlian had a ground ball there, but it is Michael Earhart grabbing it for Whipsnakes and the game's first possession. It's win and you're in for Whipsnakes. And Matt Rambo goes right to the net and scores. 15 seconds, all it took for the ball to get to Rambo and in. Joel Ocasio. Out for Chanichuk from two, he scores! Sixth two-pointer of the season for Mike Chanichuk. Only 4 seconds left on the shot clock. Coming quickly, and they score! Trenner, the diving setup.
Take that at this point, right? I mean, they just need their offense to step up.
Ground ball picked up. Whipsnakes on the attack again with numbers in transition. Trenner moves it. Connor Kelly holds it. Earhart creeping in. He'll move it, and they score!
Defense to offense. We talked about the Redwoods mistakes offensively, and here the Whips capitalize on it, quickly getting the ball upfield and then freeze it right there.
Connor Kelly moves to the middle, picked up by Larkin Kemp, moves around him. Kelly fires it home. Connor Kelly, his ninth of the season. Chanichuk, 10 to shoot, feeds it inside. Trenner, he got it. Ryan Trenner goes up and fires home his second goal today as Rambo takes it. The feed for Locascio, and he scores.
You'll see the two-man game, but the Rambo gets switched on a short stick, and now he just plants his feet, surveys the defense.
7 times they've beaten Troutner. 1 was a 2, 6 different goal scorers. And a wide open look, and there's the icebreaker. Sergio Salcido, and what was a long time coming. A game like we saw at the start of the season from Whips when they were 4-0. They started building those early leads, and now they get their 8-goal lead back as Drew Snyder picks up the most recent one here for Whips. The ability to lose a playoff game and still win a championship as Matt Rambo just under the bar.
Let's go.
And he's got himself his second goal today.
I know that's my next option if I don't get it.
Talk about the response from Burnlore, the response from Whipsnakes as a whole as Rambo comes back with another one. 1 week after being benched for the second half, he's got a hat trick and 4 points in the first. It's the third shot on goal this quarter for Redwoods as Bernhardt makes it look easy.
You can see 55 Westberg. That's an attackman that gets caught on the defensive side
for Gunnar Walt in Redwoods' net. And he is welcomed to the game by Joe Nardella. Tend to shoot for Chanichuk. Comes to goal line extended, sets up shop there. Swings it out, Hawes fires and scores! With his foot on the line, that's a one-point shot, a long one at that. Tried to feed it through for Henningberg on the doorstep, who steals it from Bernlohr, who came out of his cage. This one bouncing around, Bird takes advantage of the open net.
Credit Berg for sticking with this play and showing his quick hands. You're gonna see on this feed, it actually turns into a kind of a bang-bang ground ball.
Doesn't miss a shift after taking that hit. Kyle Harrison, and that one stopped by Bernlohr. Harrison got his own rebound, kept it moving. Doorstep goal!
You're gonna see this Harrison shot. Bernlohr's up to that. Harrison sticks with the play, picks it up, kicks it out. If you freeze it right here, you can see Paparo's actually in pretty good position. Somehow Walters is gonna weave the ball through to Henningberg. That skip pass allows Henningberg to beat the defensive rotation.
Picked up by Rambo. Rambo rolls. Rambo feeds, and they score.
Be honest with us, Matt. Was that bounce pass intentional?
I don't know, what do you think?
That's why I'm asking you.
I guess we'll let the people figure that one out themselves.
Jared Newman go about it differently, but very similar results in their two-point shot. And Snyder! And we update you again on the score differential as it is at the moment. Atlas have pulled ahead of Redwoods by three from their couches. Rambo adds to it.
Nardella picks it up and goes to the rack. You've got to respect him and the backhanded flip.
Even Rutgers product steps his way to the doorstep, but no farther. In tight and a nice feed and finish. Clark Peterson able to keep his feet out of the crease and put the ball in the net. Shot clock takes it down inside of 10. Eppel sails one ahead, and it won't go. Clark Peterson had a chance, whips, didn't call off the dogs in the defensive end though.
No, and that's the kind of play you kind of look at, you're like, Tim Muller, you think that guy cares? Like, you're gonna dive and score one late? No.
Whip so snakes.
Hats off to their defense. I mean,
they clinch a playoff spot. They clinch a top two finish. They booked their matchup for week one of the playoffs with chaos. And one of those two teams will advance to the championship. Meanwhile, Redwoods fall to 4-5. And they join the pack at 4-5. And everything will still be determined next week in Albany. That was the 27th game in the Premier Lacrosse League this season. The average margin between the scores, 2.3. This is an outlier. The 13 goal differential between Whipsnakes and Redwoods tonight. 17-14, the final from Hamilton. For Ryan Boyle, Paul Burmeister, and our entire NBC Sports crew, I'm Brendan Burke saying thank you for watching. Make sure to go to NBCSports.com for a full recap of this and every PLL game. And don't miss the action week 10 of the PLL next weekend from Albany. Coverage kicks off Atlas Chaos, 8 p.m. Eastern on NBC Sports Gold.